let's see average audit. So generally, what is average audit? A particular date, a settlement has to be taken place. Once settled, we are going to settle on a particular date. Therefore, no loss for either party. So there are two parties generally in average audit, either buyer, seller, or partnership firm or partner, something else. A particular date, a settlement has to be done so that neither loss, no loss to the either party. That's it. That particular date is called average audit. So generally, it is going to be useful for computation of interest on drawings of partners. We can use general method or average audit method, or any loan given, a particular date loan has to be settled. That is the date also, average due date. Or if the amount is lent in one installment, we can use average due date. So many days, installment wise, we got a loan. But one particular date, installment to be settled. That is also average due date. How the average due date be calculated? Right. Number one, suppose bill has been raised. Bill has been raised. Okay, right. On a specific date, no, exactly that specific date will be average due date. Example, August 15th is a due date. It means August 15th. That's it. Specific date is given. That specific date is equal to average due date. Average due date. Sometimes the bill will be given. Once a bill has been given, a number of days or number of months will be given. That's it. If number of days or number of months will be given, so due date is equal to, suppose 3 months. 3 months. Plus 3 months you have to add. Plus 3 days of grace you have to give extra. Suppose 60 days. On a particular transaction, 60 days is a due date. On a particular transaction, plus 60 days, you calculate, plus 3 days of grace. Suppose that the due date, the 3 days gets added, the due date is a general holiday, previous working day, sudden public holiday, next working day. That's it. So due date to be calculated for each and every bill based on the month or days. So due date, so a normal transaction date, due date 3 months, plus 2 months, plus 3 months, plus 4 months, or plus 60 days or 50 days. Plus days of grace. That's it. So, but generally, specific date means that is going to be due date, average due date, or days of grace will be given. Bill of exchange given. So, 60 days or 30 days or 40 days or 2 months to be added, plus 3 days of grace to be given generally. So, either bill due date to be calculated based on the bill or on a specific date. Generally, 3 days of grace, days of grace will be given for all bills. So, how to find average due date? Average due date is equal to mean or equal date. Single payment can be made in lies of different payments on different dates. Okay, so actually different dates, different payment to be matured, but one particular date, the entire payment can be given so that without loss to any either of the party. It's called average due date. So different payments on different dates are happening, but one particular date, entire payment to be paid, that's called average due date. When the payment is not made on the average due date, the party receiving the amount charges interest for as many days as payment is delayed from the average due date. The payment is not made on the average due date, the party receiving the amount of charges interest for as many days per. For example, so beyond average due date, any payment to be done, now interest to be calculated. Suppose average due date on a particular date, for example, August 1. After 70 days, after 16 days only, we made a payment. 16 days interest to be calculated along with the total amount we have to pay. That's it. Of any payment after due date, after average due date, it is going to be interest. Right. One more method. Okay, that's a model. Right. So formula to find out average due date here, base date you have to find out for the bill or anything, base date. Generally, beginning date will be base date, but any date can be base date can be taken. So base date we can take. So total products by total amounts. Total products by total amount. Generally, base date will be 0th date. 0th date will be base date. So today the base date means today we can take 0. From today onwards, 10 days after, 15 days after, 20 days after. So multiple bill we can generate. The base date generally will be 0th date, initial dates. So base date plus total product with total amount is equal to average due date. Right. But first you have to select the base date as a zero date. From the base date only, all the due dates to be calculated. From the base date to due date, 30 days, first bill. From the base date to due date, 60 days, second bill. From the base date to 3 months, third bill, just like this. From the base date, you have to calculate everything. Sequentially, you have to calculate. If there is any fraction available, you round it off. So 38.1 means 38, you can round it off. 38.9 means 39, you can round it off. Nearest multiple of 10, you can round it up. That's it. If any bill paid before average due date, ADD, rebate must be given. Any amount paid after due date, interest to be charged. Any bill before due date, rebate. Reduce the interest. Any bill to be paid after due date, add the interest. Interest to be charged. Rebate to be given. Any bill paid before due date, rebate to be given. Any bill after due date, interest to be charged. That's it. So generally, these kind of bills will be happening. any sale or purchase between two people on two different dates. From this only we can find average due date. That's the idea. Okay. So in case if two parties are involved, I am purchasing from you, A purchases from B, A purchases from B. Similarly, B purchases from A, B purchases from A. If two parties are involved, multiple transactions between two parties, it is better to find average due date by this method. So average due date is equal to base date, difference in the products, by difference in the amounts, you can find average due date. I tell you by practically later on. So meantime, just memorize, if two parties involved, one party purchases from other party, A purchases from B or B purchases from A, average due date is equal to base date you have to calculate, that's called zero to date, plus difference in the products, by difference in the amount you can take. If you take zero to date as a date, now definitely the product will be plus only we can take. Okay. Difference in the product will be difference in amount plus base date is equal to average due date. That's it. This is a model two. Right. So that's the idea. Fine. For example, how to find due date? For example, I'm telling example after taking into account days of grace. A bill or promissory note will be matured on a particular date. So generally, for a bill of exchange, due date will be given. So bill dated 30th September is made payable after 3 months after date. 3 months after date. There are two types of bill. One is after date bill, one is called after site bill. After date, date will be mentioned, after date we can take. If any bill falls due on 2nd January, okay, for example, falls due on 2nd January. So bill dated 30th September, payable 3 months. What is the weekend? 3 months means 3 months. So from 30th September, payable 3 months after date. So date is 30th September. 3 months when you get it, calculate October 30, November 30, December 30. So October 30, first 1 month. September 30 is the bill date. 1 month, October 30, November 30, second month, December 30, third month, December 30, third month, plus 3 days of grace. December 31, January 1, January 2, 3 days of grace. So January 2, plus 3 days of grace, normally to be given. So January 2. So due date for the bill, 2nd January. Due date for the bill, 2nd January. That's it. Okay. So this is the way you have to calculate. That's it. Okay. Suppose one more example. Okay. Example 2. Note date of 1st January payable 1 month after sight. 1 month after sight. What is after sight? After sight, for example, 1st January is a sight. It is actually accepted by the drawee. 1st January is the date accepted by the drawee. It's called after sight. Okay, there are 2 days. Date will be mentioned in the bill from the after date or after sight. After sight is given on the date he accepted the bill. Drawee. From 1st January, after sight. Imagine. From 1st January onwards, plus 1 month, 1 month, 1 month. 1 month means 1st February, plus 3 days of grace, which means 4th of February. So 4th of February, that's it. So 4th February is a due date, that's it. 1 month after site, after accept by the drawee, 1 month plus 3 days of grace, 4th of February, that's it. Okay. Right. Example, we'll give some example now, right. A bill date 20th January 2015 is made payable after 1 month after date. The due date of instrument is third day. Okay, now 1 month after date. Now, bill date. So January 29. You have to find due date. So due date we can find 1 month. No, 1 month means February 29 we have to put. Due date means 1 month. February 29 you have to put. But 2015 is not a leap year. Therefore, it is not a February 29. It is February 28. If it is a leap year, means February 29, 1 month. It is not a leap year. Therefore, February 28, plus 3 days of grace. February 20 is last date, 1 month, 1 month. May 1, 3 days of grace, 3 days of grace, 3 days of grace, which means May 1, May 2, May 3. So due date is equal to May 3. February 28, 3 days of grace. May 1, May 2, May 3. May 3 is equal to due date. That's May 3 equal to, sorry, March 3. March, February only, no. March 3. February 28, January 29, 1 month, February 28. It is February 29 is supposed to come, but it's not a leap year, there are February 28. Cut-off date, February 28, 1 month, plus 3 days of grace, which means after February, March 1, March 2, March 3. Our due date, March 3. That's it. If it is a leap year, February 29. Then again, March 1, March 2, March 3. Not a leap year, February 28. Again, March 1, March 2, March 3. Anyway, due date, March 3. That's it. Okay. Suppose the due date is a holiday, known holiday. If due date is a known holiday, There are two cases, two possible scenarios happen. If due date is a public holiday, maybe Sunday or any government holiday, then due date is equal to preceding working day. Preceding working day. Suppose preceding working day is a public holiday, again previous working day, again previous working day. That's it. For example, preceding business day. So due date is on Sunday. Imagine Sunday. August 16 is a Sunday. Imagine August 16 is a Sunday. Sunday. Definitely due date cannot be matured. Then previous working day. August 15. Again, August 15 is the Independence Day. A bill date, again previous working day. It's going to be August 14. Actually, August 16 is a due date. That is actually on Sunday. Again, go back to August 15, previous working day. Again, actually is independent day. Then August 14 is a due date. Due date preponed. Suppose emergency or sudden public holiday, next to working day. Suppose imagine August 16, one of the national leaders expired. Sudden emergency, sudden declaration of leave, entire India. In this case, next to working day. If there is any sudden public holiday, next to working day is equal to due date. That's it. Two things, scenarios happening, right? Okay. That's it. We'll do. Okay. We'll solve the first question. Okay. How to find average due date? Model 1. The following are the amounts due on different dates in between the same parties. Amount 500, July 3, due date. Amount August 2, due date. Amount 1000, 11 September, due date. Suggest a date in which all the bill has to be settled without any loss to either party. Anyway, total amount has to be paid in a single date. So 500 plus 800, 1300 plus 1000 plus 1000. So 2300. Anyway, 2300 to be settled on a particular average due date. This is a total amount to be settled, particular average due date. Therefore, any loss to either of the party, That's it. So what is the date? You have to find out. That's our question. Okay. Now you do one thing. There are four columns you can do. First one is called due date column. Four columns for average due date column. And amount, next, number of days. Any date may be the base date, but it is still always 0th date will be ideal one. Number of days from base date, and finally product. So due date, July 3, August 2, September 11 is already given. Don't change it. Amount 500, 800, 1000. Anyway, total amount 2300. Base date, August 2 to September 11. July 3 with the 0th date. First transaction date. That's called July 3. Assumption, July 3 is equal to base date you can take. So July 3 to July 3, 0 days. Number of July 3 to July 3, 0. July 3 to August 2. July is going to be 31 days. Leave July. July 3 to August 2. How many days? In July, leave July 3. 3 days leave it. Balance 28 days. And August 2 days. July 31 days. Leave 3. Balance 28. August 2 days. So total 30 days. So number of July 3 to August 2, how many days? 30 days. Similarly, July 3. Any date can be base date, but it is always ideal to take the 0th date for easy calculation, for easy solution. That's it. Any date can be taken as a base date. Answer remains same only, always. But 0th date will be ideal one. And July 3 to September 11. Same logic. July, how many days? 28 days. August, how many days? 31 days. September, how many days? 11 days. So 28, 31, 11. 31 plus 28 is 59 plus 11. So 70 days. So 70 days. Right. Now this is one. This is number two. This is number three. This is number four. What is number four? It's a product. No meaning at all. Simply product. So 2 into 3. Second column and third column. 0 into 500. 0. 30 into 800. 24,000. No meaning for the product. Simply multiply. 70 into 1000, 70,000. Please make a total, 94,000. This is total product amount. This is called, so total product amount. This is called, so total amount. Okay. How to find average due date? Average due date is equal to that's called ADD. Average due date is equal to base date plus total product amount by total amount. If any fraction comes the division, remove the fraction. What is the base date here? July 3 is a base date. So July 3. What is total product amount? 94,000. What is total amount? Total amount? So 2,300. So 2,300. That's it. So July 3, 94,000 by 2,300. That is equal to 40.869 days will come. 40.869 days. Why is the days? Because I took only days here. Days, 0 days. 30 days. 70 days. Therefore, for me, days only. If I take month, it's going to be month. 40.86. So July 3, 40.5. 5 and above, we can round it off to 41. 40.869, we can round it off to 41 days. So this is average due date. This is average. From July 3, 41st day is average due date. July 3, 41st day. What is the 41st day? I need at 41st, 41 day, 41 days. July 3, leave July 3. How many days in July? Totally 31. Leave 3. Balance 28 days. July 31 days, leave 3, balance 28 days. July 3. Then August, what you have to add to get 41. So it's going to be 13. 8 plus 3, 11, balance 1, 41. So July balance 28 days plus 13, you'll get 41 days. That's it. So July 3 plus 41 days is equal to August 13. July 3 plus 41st day is August 13. How, sir? Remaining July 28 plus 13, 20 plus 13, 40. Therefore, due date is equal to August 13. So August 13 is equal to average due date. This date, we have to settle 2,300 to the party. This date, 2,300, we have to settle to the party so that August 13 is the due date, 2,300 to be settled. So neither of the party will have a loss. That's it. Let's see. The following amounts are due to X by Y. Apo, Y has to make a payment to X on a particular date. That date is called average due date. So due to X, who is going to pay? Y has to make a payment to X on a particular date. That date is called average due date. Anyway, Y wants to pay off once for all on 18th March. Or option 2, once for all, 14th July. Anyway, interest calculations, 18% per annum, taken into consideration. See, any amount to be paid before average due date, some rebate will be offered. Any amount to be paid after due date, interest to be calculated. That's it. Anyway, 10th January, 500 rupees. 26th January, Republic Day, 1,000 rupees. 23rd January, due date, 3,000 rupees. 18th August, Sunday, 4,000 rupees. What is the amount to be paid in A and B? That's a question. Okay. Let's see. Anyway, total amount to be paid, 7,000, 8,000, 8,500 to be paid. So this is not a due date. It's a revised due date. Can you do revised due date? We'll do revised due date. Revised due date. What is revised due date, sir? Today, first bill, 10th January, no change. Second and 26th January, Republic Day, previous working day. So previous working day, it's 25th January, previous working day. So then 23rd March, revised working day, revised due date. 18th August, Sunday, then 17th August, previous working day. So previous working day, right? That's it. Now we'll do the calculation. Part by slow and steadily we'll do, right? First calculation, computation of average due date. That's a very important line. Computation of average due date. That's it. Average due date, okay, we need four columns. That's called here revised due date, first column, amount, second column. So number of days from the base date, number three. So total product, number four. That's it. Okay. So how to get number four, sir? 2 into 3, amount into number of days. That's it. 2 column, second column, third column. Right. What is revised date? Yes, I put revised date. 10th January, first date, revised date, 10th January. January 10th. Second one, not 26th January, 25th January. So January 25th. January, because 10/26 is a Republic Day. So previous working day. Not 23rd March. March 23rd. Similarly, not 18th August, 17th August. Because it's a Sunday, previous working day. August 17th. So January 10, January 25, March 23, August 17. August 17. That's it. August 17. What is the amount due, sir? 500. 500. 1,000. 1,000. 3,000. 4,000. Rupees. So 500, 1,000, 3,000, 4,000. It's going to be 8,500. So 500, 1,000, 3,000, 4,000. 8,500. That's it. Okay. Which date we can take based date? January 10, January 25, March 23, August 17. January 10 we can take. Base date. So January 10 to January 10, 0. January 10 to January 25, 15. January 10 to January 25, 15 days. January 10 to March 23, we have to calculate. So January 10 to March 23, we have to calculate. Calculation required. January 10 to March 23, we have to calculate. So January, how many days available? January, February, March. January 10, leave January 10, balance 21 days. February is not a leap year, So maybe assumption 28, so 28. So March 23. January remaining 21, February 28, March 33. 21 plus 28 plus 23. Please check it out. So 21 plus 28 plus 23. So 72. 72 days from the base date. January 10 to March 23, 72 days. So 72 days. So and normally 0 date is equal to base date. Okay. January 10 to January 10, 0. January 10 to January 25, 15. January 10 to March 23, 72. So January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August 17. So January 10, leave 10, balance 21 days. February 28, March 31, April 30, May 31, June 30, July 31. Add all days. That's it. So add all days. Please check it out. You'll be getting 219, I think. Please 21 plus 28 plus 31 plus 30 plus 31 plus 30 plus 31 plus 17. So 219. So 219 days. So 219 days. Right. Now 3 × 4. Number amount into number day based it. So 500 into 0. 0. 1,000 into 15. 15,000. 72 into 3,000. 216,000. So 3,000 into 72. 216,000. 4,000 into 219. 8,76,000. 4,000 to 219. 8,76,000. That's it. I want total. So 15,000 plus 216,000 plus 8,76,000. That's going to be 11,07,000. 11,07,000. That's it. 11,07,000. That's it. Now, that's it. So how to find average due date, sir? Very simple. Average due date is equal to Base date plus so total product by total amount. So total product with total amount. So base date January 10 I took. So total product 11,07,000. So total product 11,07,000. By 8,500. So January 10 is equal to 11,07,000 by 8,500. It is going to be 130.23 will come. 130.23. Okay. Please check it out. 11,07,000 by 8,500. 130.235, I think. 130.235. There are two options. Either you can round it off to 130 or 131. 130 or 131. Option only. Round it off only. January 10, round it off to 131 also you can put. Nothing wrong in it. Sir, 130 can you put? Yes, 130 also you can put. So can I take 131? 131 you can put. That is nothing wrong in it. So the question is, round it off. That's it. Round it off. Any round. Round means either 130 or 131. So that's called round off. Round off. Okay, it's up to you only. Okay, January 31, 10 to 131 days. 131 days. 131 days. So January 10 plus 131 days. 131 days. 130 also you can put. 130 also you can put. So January balance 21. February 28. March 31. Not 131 so far. April 30. May. So 21 plus 28 plus 31 plus 30. 110. So far 110. So far 110. So then 21. 110 plus 21, 131. So May 21. So this is going to be May 21 is the average due date. That's it. May 21, average due date. So here, May 21 is the average due date. So average due date is equal to May 21. That's it. That's called average due date. Right. So May 21 is the average due date. Right. Question number one. Suppose in the payment is going to be settled in. March 18th. But definitely we have to give rebate. We have to give refund. May 21 is the average due date. May 21 is the average due date. Case one. There are two cases. Case one. March 18th is settlement. In this case, what you'll do? Before May 21, March 18th. How many days are you? Please check it out. March 18th to May 21. So March 18th to May 21, how many days? March, how many days? Leave 18. March, you have 13 days. March 13 days. April 30 days. May 21 days. Please check it. Please add now. So how many days will come? 1 plus 3, 4, 64 days. May 13, April 30, March 13, April 30, May 21. Please add. So May 21 is have duty, but you are going to make a payment earlier to that. May 21, earlier, March 18. So 64 days. Please check it to 64 days. Therefore, rebate. It's called not interest, rebate. But definitely, any payment done March 18 before average due date, before EDD, payment done. Therefore, rebate is equal to, what is the amount actually? 8,500 is the amount. What is the interest calculation? 8% into 64 by 365. 8,500 into 8% into 64 by 365. It is going to be 119.2, I think. 119.2. 8,500 into 8% into 63.65. 119.2. 119.2. That's it. So this is the rebate. Anyway, so total amount to be paid on March 18. Is equal to ₹8,500 is the amount. Any payment done before average due date, rebate available. Minus 119.2, we can reduce it. 119.2. So 8,500 minus 119.2, rebate. Then ₹8,380.8. That's it. This is the amount to be paid. In case two, July 14th. In case of case two. Suppose case two, July 14. July 14th. What is average due date? Average due date? May 21. Average due date, May 21, average due date. Okay. So ADD, May 21. But amount to be settled, July 14th. After due date, up interest. After average due date, therefore interest. So first calculate, how to calculate interest. So May 21, leave May 20. May, how many days available? May 21, leave it. Then 10 days, May. 31 days, 21, leave it, 10 days. June, 30 days. So July, 14 days. So 40 plus 50, 14, 54 days. 54 days interest. So 8,500 into 8% into 54 by 365. Any payment after due date, along with interest, you have to pay. 54 by 365, it is going to be rupees 100.6. Anyway, amount to be paid on July 14 is equal to amount 8,500 plus interest 100.6. That's called 8,600.6. You have to pay. Is amount plus interest to be paid. That's it. Let's see. Calculate average due date for the following information. Date of the bill, August 10, 2015. Term 3 months. Amount 6,000. October 23, 60 days, 5,000. December 4, 2 months bill, 4,000. January 14, 60 days bill, 2,000. March 14, 2 months bill, 3,000. February to Kendi, 28. Find the average due date. Okay, first one, you have to find the due date, then you can proceed with the sums. First calculation is always due date. So August 10, first calculation always due date. So August 10 plus 3 months. August 10, June, August, after August, September 10, October 10, November 10, September 10, October 10, November 10, November 10. November 10 plus 3 days. It is going to be November 13. Due date is very, very important. Then only problem can be started. It's going to be November 13. Right. Next one. October 23, 2015. Plus 60 days. October, how many days available? October, how many days? 23 means 8 days. Totally 31, leave 23. 8 days. Plus November, 30 days. Plus December. But you have to get 60 days, no? 60. 8 plus 30, 30, 38, then 22. October remaining, 70 days over, remaining 8 days, 31 days, no? November 30. December 22 only will make you 60 days, correct, no? But December 22 is going to be due date. So December 22. Similarly, December 4 plus 2 months. It is very simple. January 4, February 4. February 4. Plus 3 days. So February 7. January 14 plus 60 days. January 14 plus 60 days. 60 days. Okay, January 14. January remaining how many days? January, ma? Leave 14. 17 days. February? 28 days. January remaining 17. February 28. Then March, you have to get 60 days. 60. So 28 plus 15, 17 already? 45. 38, 45. Balance 15. So March 15. January remaining 17. February 28. March 15. So 60. So March 15. Please check it out. March 15. Okay, plus 60. Okay, 60 days. March 15. Please check it March 15. So March 15 plus 3 days of grace. Please check it. March 15 plus 3 days of grace. Therefore, March 15 will come. Exactly 60 days, March 15 will come. Plus 3 days. Okay. That's always you have to take. Always you have to take 3 days. 3 days. Okay. 3 days. So March 18 will come. March 18. Here also, exactly 60 days. December 22. Exactly 60 days. December 22. December 22. Please check it out. So October. Balance 8 days. November 30 days. December 22 days. Plus 3 days of grace. 3 days of grace. December 25 will come. December 25 will come. But December 25 is a Christmas. So December 25 is a Christmas. Therefore, we can take December 24. Slowly think, one by one you think. October 23 plus 60 days. October balance 8 days. November 30. December 22, 60. 60 complete. December 22. But 3 days of grace we can add, no? December 25. December 25 is a Christmas. Christmas. So December 24. March 15 plus 3. March 18. That's it. Okay, well, March 18. That's a thing. Okay. Last one. March 14 plus 2 months. March 14 plus 2 months. 2 months. March 14 plus 2 months. April 14, May 14. May 14. Plus 3 days. So May 17. So first one, due dates. These are the due dates. Due dates calculated. November 13. December 24. December 25. Christmas. So previous work ended. December 24. February 7. March 18. May 17. That's it. Now we can proceed to the sum. Again, our as usual model, due dates. Number one, amount. Number two. Due date number one, amount number two. Number three, number of days from the base date. Number three. Number four, product. This question has been asked so many times, this question, product. So four is equal to second column into third column always. First, due date, November 13. Second one, December 24. Next one, February 7. December 24. February 7. November 13. December 24. February 7, March 18, May 17. Okay, November 13, December 24, February 7, March 18, May 17, that's it. Now, amount column. So 6,000. So 5,000. 4,000. 2,000. So 3,000. 6,000, 5,000, 4,000, 2,000, 3,000. That's amount. Base date, November 13, December 4, 24. December 24, February 7, March 18, May 17, due dates going on. 2015 is a normal year, but 2016 is a leap year. 16 is a leap year. So this is, 2016. That's it. Base date, November 13. The leap year starts. 2016 is a leap year. There is a leap year. Okay, right. Number 13, base date. Number 13, 0. Number 13, 0. Number 13 to December 24, you calculate. Okay, you please calculate. Number 13 to December 24. Number 13, how many days available? 17. December 24. 24 plus 17, 41, I think. Please check it out. November 17, December 24. 34, 41. 41 days, I think. Please check it out. 41 days. November 13 to February 7. Slow, slowly you have to do a lot of calculation work. November 13 to February 7. So, November, December, January, February. November 17 days. December 31 days. January 31 days. February 7 days. 7 days. So 17 plus 31 plus 31 plus 7. 80 60s. 41 days. Okay. So second one, 80 60s. Please slowly do. November 13 to February 7. Number 17 days. December 31, January 31, February 7. 31 62 62 79 86 86. Okay. 86. Okay. Next, okay, slowly you'll do. November 13 to March 18. So 5 marks or 10 marks examination paper, these models. November 13 to March 18. So November, December, January, February, March. November 13, 17 days. December 31 days, January 31 days, February leap year, 28 days, March 18, because February 26 to 16 will come. Check it out, 2016 actually, okay, so leap year. But there is assumption, eh? You have to assume 28 days, okay. Therefore, so instead of 29, we can assume 28. They're asking you to assume 28 days. Actually, 216 is a leap year. But assume February, it is going to be 28 days. Assumption. Therefore, based on the assumption only, I round it up to 28. Otherwise, I'll put 29 here. In a March 18. Please add all the dates. 17, 31, 31, 28, 18. That's it. So 17 plus 31. Plus 28 plus 18. That's it. So it's going to be 125 days, I think. Ma. Please check it out. One more time, we'll check. 17 plus 31 plus 31 plus 28 plus 18. 125 days. Okay. 40 days, 125 days. So November 13 to May 17. November 13 base date. Zero date is a base date. November 13 to May 17. November, how many days? Please calculate. November, December, January, February, March, April, May. November, December, January, February, March, April, May. November, 17 days. December 31 days, January 31 days, February assumption 28, otherwise I will take 29, March 31, April 30, then May 17. So November 13 to May 17. Okay. May 17. So calculation part completed. November 17, December 31, January 31, February 28, March 31, April 30, May 17. So please add. So 17 plus 31 plus 31 plus 28 plus 31 plus 30 plus 17 is going to be 185. That's it. Please check one more time. 17 plus 31 plus 31 plus 28 plus 31 plus 30 plus 17. 185. So 185 days. That's it. Means getting 185 days. Right. Now calculation. 0 into 6000, 0. 5000 into 41, 5041. So 2,05,000, 2,05,000. 4000 into 86. So 3,44,000. So 4000. Into 86, 3,44,000. So 2,000 into 125. So 2.5 lakhs, 2.5 lakhs. So 2,000 into 125, 2.5 lakhs. So 3,000 into 185, 5,55,000. That's it. So 3,000 into 185, 5,55,000. That's it. Okay. Now I want total. I want total. 6,000 plus 5,000 plus 4,000 plus 2,000 plus 3,000. That's it. So 20,000. So 6,000 plus 5,000 plus 4,000 plus 2,000 plus 3,000. That's it. 20,000. So 2,05,000. So 2,05,000. 3,44,000. So 2.5 lakhs. 5,55,000 is going to be, so 13,54,000. That's it. So 2,05,000 plus 3,44,000 plus 2.5 lakhs plus 5,55,000. We'll do one more thing. Okay, 3,000 into 185 more. Please check it out. 5,55,000. Okay, great. So 2,05,000 plus 3,44,000 plus 2.5 lakhs plus, so 13,55,000. That's it. So this is known as total amount. This is known as total product. Okay, total product. Now we will do, so average due date is equal to base date plus, so total product rupees by, so total amount rupees. Therefore, so base date is equal to number 13. Base date is equal to number 13 plus, so 13,54,000 by rupees 20,000. So 13,54,000 by 20,000. So number 13. So 1,354,000 by 20,000. 67.7 days. 1,354,000 by 20,000. 67.7 days. We can round it off to 68. Number 13 plus 68. So number 13. Number remaining, how many days? Number, so 13 leaves 13. 17 days. December 31. January 31. February 28. We can assume. By adding 68, I think leaving, exceeding 68, I think. So January itself also is leading 68. Okay. January itself you have to reduce. Okay. So 68 you have to do. 68. So 17 plus 31, 48, upper 20. January 20. 17 plus 31 plus 20, 68. So January 20, that's called average due date. Average due date is going to be January, so 20. So January 20 is equal to average due date. That's it. January 20, so 2000. Please check it out. 2016. Okay. Right. So 2016, January 20 is due date. So that is the date. 20,000 to be settled. So no loss to either of the, no loss to any one of the party. January 20 is the due date. That's it. Let's see. A trader has accepted the following several bills, falling due on different dates. Now desire to have these bills cancelled. Accept a new bill. Okay, sir, old bills, there are 5 bills generated. I want to cancel all the bills. I want new bill. Okay, anyway, old bill has to be cancelled on a particular date. That date is called average date. So neither of the party will going to have any loss. What is the date? So anyway, serial number, first bill, 10th March, 400 rupees, 2 months bill. Second bill, 10th March, 16, 300 rupees, 3 months bill. Third bill, 5th April, 200 rupees, 2 months bill. Fourth, 20th April, 375, 1 month bill. Fifth bill, 11th May, 216, 500 rupees, 2 months bill. Find the average due. Anyway, the five bills has to be cancelled. What is the due date? So that the entire amount, new bill can be drawn on a single bill. Anyway, the question is find the average due date where the five bill has to be cancelled. So how to solve, sir? All right. First due date. That's the first step. Okay. First bill, March 1. So 2016, March 1. Plus 2 months. March 1, 2 months. April 1, May 1. March 1, 2 months. April 1, May 1. Plus 3 days. May 1 plus 3 days. May 4. March 1, 2 months. April 1, May 1. 2 months. Plus 3 days of gas. May 4. May 4 is a due date. Right. 3 days given. 3 days added. Right. Any bill, days of grace. Sudden public holiday, previous working day, due date. Non-public holiday, next working day, due date. Sudden public holiday, next working day. That's the idea. So 2016. Now it's going to be March 10. Plus 3 months. So March 10, 3 months. April 10, May 10, June 10. March 10, 3 months. April 10, May 10, June 10. April 10, May 10, June 10. Plus 3 days. June 10 plus 3 days is June 13. June 13. Police check is going to be June 13. Next one. So 2016, April 5. 2016, April 5. April 5, 2 months. April 5 plus 2 months. So April 5 plus 2 months. Okay, April 5 plus 2 months. What date will come? April 5 means May 5, June 5. May 5, June 5. April 5, 2 months. May 5, June 5. June 5. Plus 3 days. June 5 plus 3 days. 3 days. June 8. Okay. Next 2016. April 20th. 1 month. April 20th, 1 month. April 20 means May 20 will come. April 20, 1 month. Plus 3 days. So May 23. April 20 plus 1 month, May 20. Plus 3 days, May 23. So 2016. So May 11 plus 2 months. May 11 plus 2 months. It's going to be June 11, July 11. Plus 3 days. July 11 plus 3 days. It's going to be July 14. So for May 4, June 13, June 8, May 23, 14th July. Now revised. Now due date. First column, due date always. So due date is step one. Next one, rest of things. Due date, step one is calculated. Now next column, amount. So third column, number of days from base date. Number three. Number four, product. Number four. So four is equal to, so 2 into 3. 4 is equal to 2 into 3. That's it. So due date. Okay. First one, May 4. So 2016. May 4. Next, June 13. Next one, June 8. Next one, May 23. Next one, July 14. May 23, July 14. That's it. So May 4, 13th June, June 8, 23rd May, July 14. Out of this, which one is a zero date? Zero date means May 4 only. May 23, May 4, May 4 only. Our base date, better we can take May 4. So it's easy for us. Then amount column 400, 300, 200, 375, 500. So 400 rupees. Product also rupees. So 400, 300, 200. So 300, 200. 375, 500. 375, 500. So 400, 300, 200, 400, 400, 300, 200, 400, 300, 200, 375, 500. That's it. Anyway, amount is going to be 1775. May 4 to May 4, 0. May 4 to June 13, you have to find out. So June 13. So May, 31 days, leave 4, May 4, then 27 days, then June 13 days. So 27 to 13, 40 days. So 40 days here, 40 days, 40. May 4 to June 8, May 4, base date, always zero date is a base date. So that ideal for us to do calculation easier. May 4 to June 8. So May 4 to June 8, please calculate, ma. Please calculate. Ma, May 4 to June 8, please calculate. So May, June. May, how many days? Four. Leave 4. 27. June 8. So 27 plus 8. 35. So 35 days. May 4 to May 23. May 4 to May 23. How many days? 4 to 10. I think it's going to be 19 days. So 19. May 4 to July 14. May 4 to July 14. May 4 to July 14. That's it. May, June, July. May 4, leave how many days? 27. June, 30. July, 14. So, May 27, June 30, July 14. So, 27 plus 30 plus 14. That's it. So, 71 days. That's it. Now, please check it out. 71 days. Right. So, 71 days. Rupees. 0 into 40, 400, 0. 40 into 300. So 12,000. 35 into 200, 7,000. 375 into 19, 7125. 375 into 19, 7125. 500 into 71. So 35,500. Please make a total. A total 61,625. This is going to be total amount. This is going to be total product. Okay. Anyway, you have to find average due date. So average due date is equal to base date plus total product by total amount. So base date, May 4. So total product 61625 by 1775. So 61625 by 1775. May 4 plus 61625 by 1775. That's it. May 4, 61625 by 1775. So it's going to be 34.71 will come, I think. 31.71 days will come, I think. Better we can convert into May 4. 34.71 we can convert into 35 days. Convert into 35 days. 35 days. May 4 plus 35 days. May 4 plus 35 days. May 4. Balance how many days in May? Leave 4. Leave 4. So 27. 27. So 35 you have to get. Up by 8. 8 in June. May 4 means balance days in May 27. What date you have to add to get 35? 8. 8. So up by 8. May 4 plus 35th day? June 8. June 8. June 8. Therefore it's going to be June 8. So average due date is equal to June 8. Average due date is equal to June 8, 2016. June 8, 2016. So 2016, June 8. June 8. So June 8 is going to be average due date. That's it. Let's see. Two traders X and Y buy goods from one another, each allowing the other 1 month's credit. 1 month credit normally given. 1 month credit. Plus generally 1 month credit. If X selling to Y now, 1 month credit. Y selling to X now, 1 month credit. At the end of 3 months, the accounts are rendered as follows. Anyway, goods sold by X to Y, April 18th, 60 rupees. If X sold to Y, 60 rupees. 60 rupees, right, that's it. Plus 1 month credit, 1 month credit. Just add 1 month, add 1 month, add 1 month, add 1 month. April 18 plus 1 month, ma, is going to be May 18, 1 month credit. May 15 plus 1 month, 70 rupees sold, May 15. 1 month credit. It's a due date. Actually, it's a due date. Due date. May 15 plus 1 month. It is going to be June 15. It is not a bill, no days of grace. Bill, no days of grace. It is not a bill, so no days of grace. Simply 1 month credit. That's it. June 17 plus 1 month credit. June 17, 1 month credit. Due date, July 17. So total 60, 70 plus 80, 80 plus 150 plus 60, it's going to be 210. So X sold goods, total 210. Similarly, goods sold by Y to X, April 23, 1 month credit, it's going to be May 23, due date, given by Y to X, amount 52. May 24, Y sold to X, 1 month credit time, that amount, 1 month, May 24 plus 1 month, June 24. Ma 50 plus 52 ma 102. That's it. Find the average due date in which neither party no loss to them. No loss to them. That's the idea. No loss to the either party. No loss to the either party. That's it. Find the average due date. Find the average due date. That's the question. Right. First due date already I put. Due date already I put. Right. Now first. So X rendered to X sold to Y. Okay, first one. Case one. Okay, common base date we have to select. Common base date. So common base date we have to select. That will select last. Last will select. Common base date will select. First one. First one. X sold to X sold to Y of Y payment. X sold to X. X sold to Y means Y payment. X sold to Y means Y payment. Y payment. So this is Y payment. Which means X sold to Y. Y payment. Y payment. So due date. Amount, due date, amount, number of days from base date, super sum, model 3, model 4, number of days from base date, and product. Similarly, X payment, which means Y sold to X. Y sold to X, X payment. Experiment also four columns. Due date, amount, number, base date will be always common for both payments. Number of days from base date. And here it is going to be product, right. First one, due date, May 18 due date. June 15, due date. May 18, due date. June 15, due date. July 17, due date. July 17 due date. July 17 due date. May 18, June 15, July 17. July 17. That's it. Okay. Amount 60, 70, 80. 60, 70, 80. Amount 60, 70, 80. So due date 1 month credit. May 18, June 15, July 17. May 18, June 15, July 17. Amount 60, 70, 80. So 210. Similarly, come back here. Why payments? Don't go to wasted. No, just wait. May 23. Amount May 23 due date. Why X payments? 52 rupees. Rupees 52. May 23 due date 52. June 24. May 23, 52. June 24, 50. June 24, 50. May 23, 52. June 24, 50. That's it. Now find the base date. May 18, June 15, July 17. May 23, June 24. Out of 5 days, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Out of 5 days, what is the zero date? Earliest date. Zero date. So zero date, what is the earliest date? Zero date. May 18, May, June 15, July 17, May 23, July, June 24. So May 18 is a zero date. So therefore, the base date out of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Out of 5, earliest date is May 18. That's the idea. Out of 5, earliest date is May 18. So May 18 to May 18, zero. May 18 to June 15, calculate. So May 18 to June 15, calculate. So May, leave 18, 13 days. So June 15, 13 plus 15, so 28 days. So 28 days. That's it. May 18 to July 17. So May 18 to July 17. So May 18 to July 17. May, June, July. May 13 days. June 30 days. July 17 days. So 47 plus 13. I think 60 days. 60 will come. That's it. 60 days. Similarly, waste date. Same May 18. May 18 to May 23, 5 days. Common date from both. Why payment experiment? May 18, May. Out of 5, earliest date will be common base date. May 18. May 18, here also May. Don't change the date. Common base date, both payments. May 18, May 23, 5. May 18 to June 24. May, how many days? 13. June 24. 13 plus 24, so 37. So 5 days and 37 days. That's it. So completed. Now, as usual, amount into 0, amount 0, 60 into 0, 0. This is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, product. 4 is equal to 2 into 3, 2 into 3, 0 into 60, 0. 70 into 28, 1960, please check it out. 28 into 70, 1960. 80 into 60, 4800. So total, 6760 total. 5 into 52, 260. 5 into 52, amount into days, and the base date, 5 into 52, so 260. 15 into 37, 1850. 50 into 37, 1850. 50 into 37, 1850. So total 2110. So finally computation. This is X payment, Y payment. Correct? Finally, average due date is equal to base date base date plus difference in product. See the line, difference in product by difference in amount, difference in amount, difference in amount, difference in amount, difference in product by difference in amount. What is base date actually? Base date May 18. So base date May 18. Difference in product 6760 minus 2110. Difference in product. Difference in amount, amount column here 210 amount, here 102 amount. Please add the amount. Difference in product 6760 minus 2110. Difference in amount 210 minus 102. 210 minus 102. So 210 minus 102. So 210 minus 102. So 210 minus 102. So May 18 plus May 18 plus 6760 minus 6760. So minus 2110, it is going to be 4650. I think please check it out. 4650. It is going to be 4650. 6760 product amount 1, product 2, 2110 difference in the product. So 4650. 4650 by 210 minus 102, 108. I think please check it out. 108. I think 108. 108. So May 18. May 18. 4650 by 108. By 108. So 43 days will come approximately, I think. Please check it out. 43 days will come. 43, round it off. So 4650 by 108 by 108. 43.05 will come. 43 we can take. 43.05 will come. 43.05 will come. We'll take 43.05 will come. 43.05. Round it off to 43. Round it off to 43.05 will come. If I divide, 43.05 will come. We'll round it off to 43. Round it off to 43. Right? Division 43. So May 18 plus 43 days. May 18 plus 40 days. May, how many days? May 18. Leave 18. Leave 18. Leave 18. 13 days. May 13 days. 31 total. So June 30. Then only 43 will come. Then due date 30. Then due date May 18 plus 43. It is going to be June 30. So June 30. So average due date is equal to June 30. June 30. So, okay. Average due date is equal to June 30. June 30. So average due date is equal to June 30. Right. Okay, that's the date. Who is going to settle? So generally here, X pay X to Y. Y payment is more than X payment. Y payment is more. Y payment is more than X payment by 108 rupees. X sold to Y 210. Y sold to X 102. Y has to make a payment to X extra 108. Then the settlement will be done. So average due date June 30. June 30. Y to settle. Okay. Right. So very clearly given Y to settle. Rupees. Or Y has to pay. Rupees X. So 210 minus 102. 102. Rupees 108 he has to settle on June 30. Then neither party will have a loss. He has to settle Y to X on June 30. So neither party will have a loss. That's it. Sum over. Subscribe to our YouTube channel Style Digitech and press the bell icon to see new videos.